I say what? Do something.
Now what? What is he doing?
Maybe he's walking.
Maybe? Like dancing or walking?
No. Run.
Oh, running. Maybe. Okay. Let's see. Okay, let's see. Let's listen and let's see what is going on in this photo. So give me a moment to play this audio to read and listen. Okay. Just give me a moment. So it's number 16. Listen.
Listening 16. Listen and read.
Festival day. I run to the window, hear the sound of the beat. Everyone is clapping outside in the street. I hear the drums that thump and bang. I look at the cymbals sparkling as they clang. I run outside and hear the sound of people tapping their feet on the ground. The band plays slowly, one, two, three, and I can feel the rhythm all around me. The trumpets honk and sound like thunder. The players puff their cheeks as I listen in wonder. The birds are so excited, I see them flap their wings. They join in with the music, I can hear them all sing. When I grow up, I really want to play in a music group and enjoy music every day.
Well, now tell me, what is happening now in this photo?
Is the boy run to the window and he can hear sound of music.
Yep, why? Why are you playing the music? Why they're playing music? Because it's festival?
Yes.
Okay, do you like to go to a festival?
Yeah.
Yeah? For example, what festival? We have color festival, we have music festival, we have food festival. So which one do you like to go?
Maybe food festival.
Oh, food festival, of course. I do agree with you because you can find lots of delicious meals. So I like it. Okay.
I like food festival because I want to eat any food and they have this thing when I go to somewhere that maybe when I go to your country, it has hamburger, but I don't have a chance to eat it. But in food festival, I can have a chance to eat it, so I know if it's yummy or not.
Of course, I do agree. So you have a chance to try everything. Maybe lots of food, and after that you can decide whether they are delicious or not. Yeah, good. I do agree with you. So, maybe food and cake and sweets. Wow. Okay, and now, underline these words in the text and guess their meaning. Okay, symbols. Do you know symbols? Do you know the meaning of symbol?
No.
What do you think about this? Let me show you.
Oh, I know it. It's a big trunk. Oh.
Ah. Let you know. Yeah, so first of all, can you tell me if it's an instrument or no?
It's an instrument.
Of course. And another word, that is sparkle.
Sparkle. What? Is thing is have.
Yeah.
I think it have.
Spark-like, you know.
Yeah. I think it have. This one.
Which one? I can't see. Okay, so let me see. Okay, so are you sharing something?
I will send it for you.
Okay, very good. Let me check.
Everything is pearl everywhere.
Yeah, of course. It's bright, shiny appearance. Bright, shiny. Yeah, like in a flashing light. Yeah?
It has sparkle.
Of course, very good. And now, tap your feet. What it means?
Is you tap your feet.
Okay, can you find it in the photo?
Huh?
Can you find it? Something related to... Like this. I think this boy is tapping his feet like this, bum 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 bum, and ground.
It's the ground.
Of course. Rhythm.
No, I don't know rhythm.
Okay, rhythm is something related to the music. But what it means, let me explain it. For example, when you listen actually to music and, you know, it's something like you can hear a beat, a regular pattern, repeated pattern, like, for example, this is a rhythm. Okay, so it's something like a pattern or, for example, a regular pattern of sound. This is, for example, like la 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 la. This is another one. And bum, 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 bum. Okay, so they have different rhythm. And okay, how about thunder? Do you have any idea about thunder?
Thunder, I think it's thunder.
Of course, especially sometimes when stormy. Yeah, we have thunder. And chicks.
Chicks? Not this one.
Chicks. This is chin. This is chicks. Okay, well, and wings, you know? Wings. And you know, they are, you know, you can see their rhythm. Rhythm. Okay. Now, let's answer this question. Read again and match the questions and answer. What are the people clapping in the street? So, I'm sorry, where are the people clapping? So, in the street, they're clapping in the street. What is making a clanging noise? Clanging noise.
It's clanging.
You can read it and then you can understand what is clanging. It's something like when I hit to metal.
That's the clang.
What?
This means sparkling as they splash.
No, let me show you something. Just give me a moment. I'm going to show you something. Just wait a minute. Wait. Okay, wait, hold on. I'm going to play something. And now let me share my screen to show you. Clanging cymbal. Let me share my screen now. Okay.
Paul writes in 1 Corinthians 13, chapter 1, if I speak with the tongues of humans or angels, I'm a noisy irritant, a wonderful is to ensure that. Annoying, right? The apostle is someone who speaks words, irritating, annoying in its.
Oh, it's not the one that I want. Just give a moment. It's not the one that I look for. So where it is. Okay, I think here. Well, this one is better.
First Corinthians 13:1. Though I speak in the tongues of angels and above, I have become. Okay, something very interesting about this verse. I just wanted to share this real quick. Something God taught me a long time ago. I can tell somebody all day how much I love them. I can even act like I love them. That is like they are. This is if I don't keep banging, right? If I don't keep doing that, you don't keep hearing the noise.
Clanging.
The thing about a trumpet or any brass instrument.
Okay, now what makes? Okay, now let me share the book again, and you tell me. Okay, so you tell me what is making a clanging noise?
Yes, the cymbals.
Good job. And what is making a tapping sound?
The people feet.
Yes, and what instrument sounds like thunder?
The trumpet.
Good job. And what are the birds doing?
Singing.
Yeah, they're singing. Okay, now it's time to listen and number the pictures, okay? And then decide whether they are true or false. Ready?
Ready.
Great job.
Listening 17. Listen and number. Number 1.
Last month, there was a festival in the park. From my house, you could hear drums, trumpets and singing. There were lots of people there. I went with my mum and dad. We saw a band playing.
Number 2.
It's the weekend. And these children are going to the park with their parents. They usually go by car. They love listening to music and singing during the journey.
Number 3.
Sandy has her piano lessons every Tuesday after school. She practices for about 30 minutes every day. She usually practices after she has her dinner, but she doesn't practice on Saturdays.
Number 4.
These three cousins can all play the recorder. They all have lessons at school. They play very well. Often they play for their parents, and last month they played in a school concert. Their parents are very proud of them.
Well, number 2.
True.
No.
Number 4.
I want to know. First number the pictures and then decide whether this statement is true or false. So, number the pictures.
It's D, Tuesday.
D and number 3?
Number 3 is A.
And last one? Okay, now Pete and Lucy are going to a park. True or false?
True.
Sandy's piano lessons are on Friday.
False.
Okay, so when? When are they?
Tuesday.
And these cousins played in a festival.
True.
Good job. Okay, Hannah, tell me about the instrument that you can play. You can play the piano, right?
Yeah.
How well you can play? How well?
What do you mean?
It means, are you good at playing?
Yes. Maybe it just medium.
Oh, so you're not professional, but you are good at it. I think you're good at it. So good and not so bad.
Yeah, of course.
And do you like singing?
40%.
A 40% like singing? How about music?
30%.
30%. And how about, you know, the music that you like? What music do you like?
I like not Vietnamese English. No, not Vietnamese music. What is English?
Okay, so tell me a name. We're going to watch together, so tell me a name. Whose music?
Wait,
let me remember. Of course.
I know, I typed it for you.
Okay, so let me check. Then we can watch it together.
I cannot write.
So why?
Alan Walker.
Let me check. Or Tyvek?
No.
So.
But because I don't know.
Okay, so tell me the name of singer.
I will read for you.
Oh. Alan Walker, okay, so. Let me check. Good taste. Well. Really?
Wow.
Good job. If you like it, that's really interesting, so. So, Alan Walker. Okay, so let's listen. Do you want to listen one song together?
Maybe. Yes.
Okay, so. Let me, this song, Who Am I? Or, let me check something. Okay, Alan Walker. So, let me share the screen. We can decide together.
Alone? Yeah.
Lost in your mind. I wanna know, am I losing my mind? Never let me go. I know I'm not alone. Anywhere, whenever, apart but still together. I know I'm not alone. I know I'm not alone.
Kathleen, why do you like it? Why do you like the song?
Just because I like it.
Just because you like it? Okay, maybe it makes you happy?
Yeah.
Yeah, it makes you excited and happy?
Yes.
Okay, so let me share my screen again. So maybe we can say because
it's interesting.
It makes me happy and
nice,
excited and
nice and interesting.
Okay, so the song is interesting because the song is interesting, not me. I'm not interesting. The song is interesting. The song is interesting, so I am interested in this song. I'm interested in this song. It means I like it, so it makes me happy and it makes me excited. Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, Hannah, look at this part, please. You know the time that we use when we are talking about something that is happening right now. For example, now we are talking. You are listening to me. We are starting. So you know that we use ING form of verb. But you know, sometimes when we want to add ING, we need to double, the ending letter. For example, stopping, double P. So, when actually the word has one syllable and ends in one consonant like P, like for example, like, and before we have vowel, so we need to have vowel, okay? So like clap, clapping, stopping. After P, we have O, that is vowel. After P, we have A, that is vowel. So we need to double consonant, like tapping, P, and after that A, A is vowel. So we say tapping, okay, double P. So we need to learn, okay, the correct spelling of the words, okay? Now, seek out the verbs that follow the double consonant rules.
Tapping.
Okay, and do you know any other verb?
Running,
yeah, and for example, do you know any other one? So for example, how about chatting or cutting or clapping or planning? Yeah, so yeah. We have, let me write here, chatting or cutting. Yeah, so as you can see, we have vowel and after that a consonant like N, like P, like T, and we need to double the consonants. Wow, okay. And now here, we started about dinosaurs, so you know lots of things about dinosaurs. Do you like to go and visit a museum?
No.
No, wait, you don't like. So for
because
example,
I think it's boring.
You find it boring. Of course, maybe it can be boring for you. So, and now tell me, if you want to go to museum, what type, you know, what music do you like? For example, something like art museum, about paint. Yeah, art is good. So you like it?
Yes.
Of course. Okay, now let's have a look at these words. Dinosaur, museum, model, skeleton. May I ask you to read these words from the beginning?
Dinosaur, museum, model, skeleton, scary, scream, raw, alive, dead, robot.
Okay, now let's play a game. Can you use all those words, in two or three, maybe four sentences together? Oh. Let's make a fun story. For example,
alive and dead. I alive and I will dead.
Okay, so for example, I say, last year I went to a museum. And in the museum, there were some models of dinosaurs, and there were models of dinosaurs, and there was a skeleton as well. They were, I think, scary. And suddenly I heard someone was screaming, you know, but I said they are not alive, they are dead. But, you know, people were scared. And, you know, after that, we decided to go to a zoo to see a lion. But, you know, when lions started roaring, we all scared. So we are human. We are not robots. It's your time. Okay, now your turn. Make some sentences. Can you?
Yeah. Okay. Last week, I saw a model skeleton in a laboratory. And I was scared.
You were scared.
I was scared. And my friend screamed.
And
my teacher said, next week we will go to the museum.
Oh, said you would go to the museum and?
We saw a dinosaur skeleton.
Oh, you saw a dinosaur skeleton?
No, it's just a sentence.
Ah, of course. Of course I know. And how about roar and robots?
Roar and robots. And at the weekend, I go to the zoo with my family. And we saw a lion are roaring.
So, okay, you went and you saw, or you go and you see, which one?
I went to the zoo.
You went?
And we saw a lion are roaring.
Oh, was roaring. Yeah, a lion was roaring. Okay, good. Yeah, of course. Well, now, we're going to play these roles. Okay, you're going to be Max or Amy or Mom or Holly.
Mom and Amy, go to this one.
Okay, so I'm Max and Holly. So let's get started. Max.
We didn't go to school today. We went to the dinosaur museum. It was brilliant fun.
Look, I bought this dinosaur model. Oh, wait, what did you do there?
Oh, I'm Holly.
I will Holly. I be the little girl. I want to be the little girl.
Okay, so I'm Holly and Max. Yeah? Okay. Okay,
no, Holly. I think Holly is the girl with black hair.
So, okay, so you want to be Holly?
Holly.
Okay, so you are Holly. Read.
We saw dinosaurs, skeleton, and bones.
And we learn all about how dinosaurs lived.
And I'm mom, or you?
No. Wow, that sounds really exciting.
Okay, I'm okay, you're Amy, so all of you, Amy. Okay, so now you're Amy? Or yes. Me? Okay, me. Okay, but then something scary happened.
Yes, and we all screamed.
What happened?
Suddenly, one of the dinosaurs roared really loudly. I thought it was alive and I screamed.
Alive?
Yes, but it was Holly. The dinosaur was a robot and she was making it move by using the controls.
Okay, so as you can see, okay, we have all the list of verbs. As you can see, for past form, we need to change them by to.
Bought, eat, to, ate. Go to went, hear to hear, learn to learnt, make to made, see to saw, think to thought, wear to wore, write to wrote.
Good job. Okay, now let's complete this part together. Number two.
I did. By a postcard. My sister saw her friends. We didn't eat our sandwiches inside.
We didn't eat, of course. And now let's complete this one using irregular verbs.
We went to a museum to learn about the life of children 2,000 years ago. Most children that didn't go to school and didn't learn to read. Many children played games in the street and with yo-yos and wooden toys. Boys didn't wear trousers. They were short tunics.
They wore
short tunic like a dress.
Yeah, of course, just they wore, not they were. Okay, they wore. Okay, very good. And now, okay, tell me, where did you go on? Where did you go on, for example, a picnic? Did you go to the picnic? If yes, where did you go?
No.
No?
In the past, I didn't go, and in the future, maybe.
Maybe. Okay, so tell me, where did you go last weekend?
Last weekend, I go to my grandma's
house. Beep.
I went to.
Yes. Okay. And tell me.
Played with my cousin again.
What did you eat?
I ate rice again.
Beep.
I ate rice again.
Okay. And what did you see?
I saw a bird.
You saw a bird, okay, and did you buy anything?
I bought some slime to play.
And did you have a good day?
Yes, I did.
Okay, very good. And now let me ask another question, okay. Tell me, remember yesterday, And tell me, what did you do from morning to night?
I learned.
Then, just learn? No, let me say, for example, yesterday I woke up at 4 a.m. And then I brushed my teeth, and then I actually
eat breakfast.
Of course, yes. I played chess. Okay, so again, no, it's not good. Okay, so again, first of all, when did you wake up? After that, what did you do? So tell me.
I woke up at 7.
And
I brushed my teeth.
Then
I go outside and ate breakfast.
Then you go.
I went outside to eat breakfast with my family.
Oh, and after that?
After that, I went back home to learn English.
Later?
Yeah.
Oh, so later and later. So tell me, do you study English every day?
No, I study English in the paper my teacher at school gave
some worksheets. So your teacher,
I learn vocabulary and read books.
Very good, excellent to you. Okay, and now what did you eat?
I don't remember.
Okay, very good. So, Hannah, let me ask you a question. When you see someone, for example, for the first time, what do you say? You say hello and?
And how old are you?
Why you ask how old is she?
Hello. Nice to meet you.
Okay, nice to meet you. And?
What are you doing?
Oh, what are you doing? But you don't know. But you don't know. This is the first time that you meet.
What's your name?
Oh, what's your name? Of course, it's good. What's your name? Okay, so and don't you introduce yourself?
Yeah, I introduce myself.
Okay,
I introduce myself and I ask, how old are you?
Okay, so why do you ask how old she is or how old he is?
I forgot. It's
important?
No.
Of course it's not. Okay, well, and now let's have a look at this part. First of all, let's read and repeat. So listen to this one. Just give me a moment.
Listening 21. Listen and point.
Listen.
Flamingo. Scarf. Feet. Phone. Nephew. Alphabet.
Listen and repeat.
Say.
Flamingo.
Flamingo.
Scarf.
Scarf.
Feet.
Feet.
Phone.
Phone.
Nephew.
Nephew.
Alphabet.
Okay, so how these words are the same? Can you tell me? How they are the same?
It has the word. It has the word.
So,
flamingo is F, and scarf have F, and feet have F, and they are the same.
Of course.
Nephew and alphabet have
PH. So it shows that sometimes, of course, we know the letter F sounds F. Letter F sounds F. But about sometimes, the combination of letter like PH sounds F as well, like phone, nephew, alphabet. And of course, we have different, you know, letters, you know, not only PH, we have CH, SH that makes actually different sound. Now, let's have a look at this one and let's read. Circle the words with PH and with F. So.
Yesterday, an uncle and his nephew went to the zoo together. Now they are talking on the phone about the animals. They saw elephant, giraffe, flamingo. Found about the animal. They saw elephant, giraffe, flamingo, and fish. They took lots of photos. They had a good time. There are 26 letters in the English alphabet. Five are vowels. Can you say your alphabet? One is cold. I wear a hat and a scarf. And on my feet, I wear boots.
Oh, on my feet, I wear boots. Okay, but you didn't underline and you didn't mention the words with letter F and PH. I underlined them.
Oh.
Of course, I underlined them. Okay, so it's your time. So let's complete these words using F or PH. The first one, scarf. This one?
I write and I send it for you.
Good job. Scarf. Photo, phone, good job, flamingo, yeah, feed and the few, and frog. Okay, good job. Well, okay, what do you know about dinosaurs? Do you remember anything about dinosaurs? We learned about this.
Huh. Disappeared 65 million years ago.
Why?
Why was this? Some scientists think that a large rock called an asteroid fell to Earth from space. This made the Earth much colder, and there was no longer any food for the dinosaurs to eat. The most famous dinosaur is T-Rex, Tyrannosaurus Rex. It was 40 meters long and 5.5 meters high, bigger than a house. Its long tail helped it move quickly, but no one knows how fast it could run. Its teeth were 36 centimeters long, and it ate meat. You can see T-Rex skeleton in some museum. Scientists study dinosaur bones to find out how they live and what they look like. There were more than 700 different types of dinosaurs. Some dinosaurs ate plants and others ate meat. Some walk on two legs and others walk on four legs. Some could fly and others live in sea. We know they were all different, but no one knows what color or pattern they were. This is because there is no dinosaur skin left to study.
Oh, so we don't know because we don't have dinosaur skin, so we don't study, so we don't understand our skin. So, okay, and now let's, okay, do this one together. There were lots of different types of dinosaurs. An asteroid is?
An asteroid is very big dinosaur. A large rock.
Yeah, an asteroid was actually a large rock from space, and scientists think that actually they, you know, this rock, as you can see here, so that's actually called an asteroid, fell actually to Earth from space, and this made the Earth very cold, and there was no longer any food for dinosaurs, so they died. When the asteroid fell,
the Earth became very cold.
Yes, the dinosaur disappeared.
It's because it was
and the T-Rex is
a very big dinosaur.
Yes, a very big dinosaur. Very good. Okay, well, and now let's listen and number the pictures. Okay, just listen and circle the word that you hear.
Listening 24. Listen and number. Number 1.
I'm Jane. On our school trip, we saw very old pictures and old plates and pots. We also saw some bones from dinosaurs and a very old car. But my favourite part of the trip was seeing a dinosaur skeleton. It was huge.
Number 2.
My name's Simon. We saw lots of different animals on our school trip. My favourites were the monkeys and the lions. There were lots of snakes, but I didn't really like them. I hope we can go back soon.
Number 3.
I'm Lisa. We went to the beach and spent a lot of time on a big boat. We went to some islands and the boat went around them. Afterwards, we looked at rock pools on the beach and all the different plants and animals that live in them. It was really good fun on the boat. That was definitely my favourite part of the day.
Number 4.
I'm Max. On our trip, we learnt about where our food comes from. We saw animals that give us milk, like cows and goats. My favourite part was a long walk through fields which were growing different kinds of food.
Well, so, okay, number 2. A or B or D?
Number two is B.
Number three, A or D?
Three is A.
And of course, the last one, D. Okay, tell me, what are children's favorite things? So in the first one, car or skeleton?
Skeleton.
Okay, how about the second one? Monkey or snake?
Monkey.
And how about the third one? Boat or plant? Okay, and the last one?
Cows.
Good job. Okay, you got it. Okay, well, and now, my dear Hannah, like always, time is over and we need to go, but next session we will have something interesting to talk about. So do you have any questions?
No.
So have a good night.
Bye-bye, teacher.
Goodbye, Hannah. Goodbye.